What if I told you that we can use a PoE injector, but in reverse? This is one of the first models of PoE injectors. This one is from MikroTik. The way it worked, it was pretty basic. You connected the internet line on this end, so this is an input. You add in an external power supply on this output, connect another cable that will power up your PoE device. As I said, is the most simple version that was available out there. But we're not gonna talk about this. Our discussion is gonna be this little guy. This is a PoE splitter compatible with AF and AT standards that will supply 5 volts and up to 2.4 amps. Even if they look similar, they're quite different. The input is on the left side, and on the right side, we have two cables. One for data, this is 100 megabit per second, is not gonna be gigabit anymore, and a USB-C output. This is really handy if you want to power up some movement sensors or some other small devices if you do not have a power socket nearby, but you do have a PoE Ethernet connection available. But it's 2.4 amps, so I wonder what else can we power. First thing first, this blue cable is connected to my PoE switch. So I will plug it in here. We have a light, so we know that we do have power at this end. Next step, I'm gonna take a USB tester. The output will be connected right here. This is also starting up. This is just a long USB-C to USB-C cable that will help connect to different devices. Type-C output. Now we're ready to test a few things. The first thing that I would like to try is this Raspberry Pi 5 unit with an LCD screen, because it will be really nice if I can use it in wall as a kiosk. It will be very easy to mount it. Just bring an Ethernet cable in the back, then I can split it with this little guy and I'll have both power and Ethernet connection. I already tested the Ethernet connection, it works. Right now, I'm just wondering if it's gonna power up. So, let's connect it. Remember, we also have the LCD plugged in. We see that we are drawing already 1 amp. 1.2. And it's starting. Most likely we'll get the error that insufficient current available, we're not using an official Raspberry Pi power supply. Yes, we are, but it doesn't matter. It starts with the screen attached, so it can work very nicely as a kiosk. Power bank, input USB-C. It's starting to charge 1.8 amps. So it's right now, you can see over here, it's already drawing 9 watts from it, 9.37 watts. Really nice. How about the phone? This one, I think it has fast charge, I honestly don't know. Samsung A40, I think. Charging 1.7 amps. I don't have another big consumer in order to reach that 2.4 amps limit. But anyway, this is really nice. It could come in very handy. I found this gadget to be very interesting and has a lot of uses. That's it for this short video. I hope that you enjoyed it. And if so, please don't forget to like and subscribe.